Let's all be real for a second. Can you actually imagine yourself going cross country on a KTM? You're more likely to break your back on the RC, but the Duke also has a few problems. They just aren't meant for that type of thing. But what if I told you that there's a more cost-effective option, which is much more comfortable and has basically the same engine? Well, this is the new Dominar 250.
It is Bajaj's answer to the folks who absolutely adore the idea of a comfortable KTM that can literally tackle any terrain and you don't have to spend an excess of 2 lakhs for the bike.
But the Dominar has always been much more than that. It hasn't always sulked in the shadow of the KTMs. In fact, the Dominar 400 has quickly risen up to be one of the most iconic bikes that India's ever had, with other icons in the list like the R15, Pulsars and your CVRs.
The Dominar 250 is basically the Dominar 400, but has an engine swap underneath.
Well, instead of the 393cc one-cylinder motor that you find in the Dominar 400, this, like you guessed it, has the 249cc single-cylinder engine from the Duke 250. And that's a very significant choice if you think about it, because they could have gone for the Duke 200 engine, but they went for the 250 engine because that's what the Dominar stands for: affordable performance.
So, is the Dominar as great as it looks on paper? Is it just a dulled down Duke 250? Is it a proper Dominar product? The Dominar 250 surely isn't as fast or as aggressive when it comes to acceleration. It isn't as sharp as the Duke 250 in handling, even the brakes aren't as sharp. They have taken all of the sharp edges from the KTM and have rounded them off. But that isn't a bad thing, because it opens up a completely new plethora of skill sets for the Dominar 250. Touring. They have extended the wheelbase by almost 100mm for better high-speed stability. The riding position is much more laid back and comfortable for long-distance journeys. It might be slightly lacking in power compared to the Duke, but all of the torque is in the low and mid-range of the power band.
All of these little changes have added up to make the Dominar an epic cross-country cruiser, and it is much more easier to ride than the KTM and is far more comfortable. Whereas in the KTM you will have to stop at the orthopedics clinic to straighten out your back, the Dominar, you don't have to do any of that. The Dominar 250 has been absolutely showered with features. You get LED lights up front for the headlamps, you get dual channel ABS, backlit buttons, a perimeter frame, a dual barrel exhaust, and the list goes on. And when you look at the looks, well, you can see it's absolutely mature and sophisticated looking, unlike the KTMs, which are a bit more childish to say the least. And when you look at the design, you can see all of the Ducati Diavel inspirations all over the bodywork. Well, there are a few things that I don't like about this bike, and starting off, they've chosen to remove the classic Dominar 400 characteristic, which was the gear indicator over here right near the fuel tank. That was kind of like one of the things that should have remained, but they've removed. Well, the other thing which is very important and is a safety feature are the tires. Well, I would like maybe fatter rear tires like the Dominar 400, because when you're going around corners and you're trying to lean in, you feel sometimes that you're losing confidence in the bike. Whereas the bike can grip, that's not a problem at all. But still, just for confidence reasons, maybe you should change the tires. So, what are my final thoughts about this bike? well, it's not as aggressive or as brutal as the KTMs when it comes to acceleration, handling and braking. It's much more refined, much more comfortable. It's meant for a sophisticated rider. It can do cross country very easily and you won't have to go to the clinic to straighten out your back as often as a KTM would. And well, for 1.6 lakh rupees, I don't think there's a bike that can match the amount of comfort and cruising ability that the Dominar 250 offers.
Before you sign off, do check out Garve Bajaj. They provide sales, spares and service at all of their dealerships. They have one of the most expansive dealership networks across Pune and they have everything from your normal Bajaj CT100 all the way up to the Dominar 400. We have provided their contact information down in the description and as well as all of their dealership locations across Pune. So please do check them out.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Like, share and subscribe. Tell me what you think about the Dominar 250. Would you buy it over a Duke 250 or would you go for something else? Comment all of that in the comments down below and thank you for watching.